Bumps gave us a job. Spent the first 2 months trying to find Bumps. It was like an ongoing joke in the business is try to find Bumps, because he would give you a time he was going to be in a certain place. Time was wrong and the place was wrong, or one or the other, or both.
And then Bumps would do sessions with Sam Cooke and the other artists that they had, and he'd give the tapes to Lou and I, and we would log the tapes. We would grade the intro, grade the first 8 bars, grade the second 8 bars, the bridge, blah, blah, blah. And then we'd give it to Bumps, and he would analyze that, and then he would pick out the tapes based on our recommendations that he wanted to listen to, and then he would splice them together if he felt necessary.
He was a teacher, Bumps Blackwell, and he put us through school. We would take the demos and take an individual song and break it down, why the verse was good, how the transition to the bridge, if there should have been a chorus, if all those kinds of things that eventually makes you understand songwriting and what is a good song.
Bumps was a good guy, and he really was passionate about music and was fun working for him.
You know, we were being educated, and Herb had some of it, having been a musician. I had none of it. I just had what Herbie had taught me up to that point. I knew melody and I knew lyrics. I might not have known melody, I knew lyrics. We started working with a couple of groups that were on the label, a couple of artists, and eventually, in a very short time, I became very close friends with Sam Cooke, and to a point where I lived with him a little bit. And Herbie and I became generally close to Sam friends. He called us new kids in town.
Sam Cooke was really a special artist. I learned a lot from Sam when he told me that people are just listening to a cold piece of wax and it either makes it or it don't. You know, that really resonated with me. I know he came out of the gospel field and he was just listening for the feel. He wasn't listening for the incidentals. He wasn't listening to see if it was in tune, out of tune, you know, all the things that technical people listen for. He was listening like a jazz musician, and he was, you know, not a jazz musician, and very instinctive. So it was a wonderful experience working with him.
You Send Me has already hit, and his first record and his second record. He's starting to become a star. In that particular period, if you had a hit record, you were a star. You just needed one. You could be gone by the next one, but for that time, you were a star. And he recorded one of our songs, All of My Life, was the title.
Waited for you. Well, if we wrote a song that we thought Sam would like, we'd give it straight to Sam. It was that type of organization. It wasn't strict at all. Then we collaborated with Sam and wrote Wonderful World, which was, you know.
We were related, you know, we were living the life. I mean, not financially, maybe we're all in the same place. It just felt better, you know.